another exciting episode of my series titled the Biafran series. I want to specially welcome each and every one of us. Thank you for following me on this series. Thank you for your likes. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for everything you have done. If you're just seeing my face for the first time, please don't forget to click on the subscribe button. I have other videos before this one. Do well to watch them. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much. I really, really do love you. And I appreciate, guys. Today is another series, is another episode on the Biafran series. And today we are going to be talking about how the Biafrans fought the war. If it's something you're interested in watching, please watch this video to the end and drop your comments at the end of it. Give this video a thumbs up at the end if you enjoyed watching it. So guys, after Biafra had been declared by Colonel Ojukwu, there were great jubilations in the East, and each and every one of in the East was happy. They felt that at least their trials had come to an end. But unfortunately for them, these jubilations were short-lived as the Nigerian troops fired their first shot at Gakem Ogoja, which is a now cross river state.
With the second highest,
the war began with great confidence on both sides. Gowon was heard to have predicted that the war would end in a matter of days and not even weeks. And those of the East, trusting their resilience and their ingenuity, was said to have also predicted that the Nigerians will go back in a few months or be forced to negotiate. The Nigerian army started attacking from Ogoja. They pushed forward to Nsukka, where they took over the university town, and of course they took over the university, which had already been renamed the University of Biafra by then, and they destroyed Nsukka. But unfortunately, they could not move further. On 9th of August 1967 precisely, the Biafrans captured the Midwest, and towns like Uromi, Ubiaja, Benin, Warri, Sapele, Ugeli were captured by the Biafrans and occupied. The Midwesterners, there was no much resistance from the army of the Midwesterners. 9 out of the 11 top officers were already Eka Igbos, who are seen to be first cousins of the Igbos, and of course they welcomed the Biafrans. A week later, Ojukwu gave further orders to proceed to the west, and exactly on the 16th of August 1967, the Biafrans crossed the Fuzu River, which is known to be the border of the West. By 20th of August, the Biafrans had gotten to Ore, which is a city in the West. This city is about 230 miles away from Enugu, 130 miles away from Lagos, and 5 miles into the West. The capture of Ore opened the eyes of the Biafrans to the fact that there was indeed a war, and that the Biafrans were ready to fight. Unfortunately, Victor Banjo betrayed Ojukwu. Victor Banjo was a Westerner who was imprisoned in the East by Agbe Ironsi for allegedly plotting against him. He was released by Ojukwu, and rather than go back to the West to face the Northerners and their revenge, he decided to stay back and fight for the Biafrans. Fortunately, he betrayed Ojukwu, went into talks with Awolowo, and at the time began to plan to kill Ojukwu. He was later arrested by Ojukwu, and execution together with some of the men he had co-opted into the coup, which included Alele and of course Emmanuel Ifeajuna. Remember Emmanuel Ifeajuna from our 1966 coup? The damage of the attempted coup was enormous, and it wanted to bring down the spirit of the fighters of Biafra. And unfortunately, on October 1967, Enugu fell from Lagos. Gowon was said to have predicted the end of the war by the end of the year 1970, after he later went on to predict by March 1968. But unfortunately, like we all know, the war forged on. The fight was indeed very tough, and the Nigerian troops moved to capture the Eastern Origin, the cities of the Eastern Origin, and the Biafran troops resisted them by all efforts. By March, 1968, the 2nd Division of the Nigerian Army finally entered Onitsha. This was after they had tried to enter from Abagana, and of course, we remember the Abagana ambush. By rainy season of 1968, the capital of Biafra had moved. The secret of Biafran's survival was partly because they had a very good leader, which was Ojukwu. And of course, partly because he had the enormous backing of the people. The people were solidly behind Ojukwu. The army and even Ojukwu could not afford the war without the backing of the people. The poor amongst them donated and contributed in their various communities. The rich emptied their foreign bank accounts, their local bank accounts, just to see that the war forged on. The tailors made uniforms for the men. The cobblers were making shoes. Even school teachers and priests gave up their bicycles for the troops. The drivers and the taxi drivers drove the troops around. Everyone contributed in one way or the other. It was a fight to finish. It was a fight for their lives. It was a fight to leave Nigeria. Of course, there were traitors, as could be seen in every war, but there was no riot. There was no mutiny. There was no demonstration. Rather, the killings, the hunger, further intensified the efforts of Biafrans to fight more. Exactly on 15th of April, 1969, Umuahia failed, and the last man to leave the town was Ojukwu himself. The war waged on for a period of 30 months, and by mid-January 1970, after Owerri had been recaptured by the federal troops, Anuli Airport was under heavy attack and assault by the federal troops led by Olusegun Obasanjo. The end of Biafra was near. Of course, we also know about the blockade of food, which caused great hunger in the land. Children were dying.
With the second highest death toll.
And this was one of the reasons that Biafrans became very tired. By this time, Ojukwu had already left to Ivory Coast, leaving behind Philip Effion, who was the second in command. He went on to announce to the troops to lay down their guns and to stop fighting, and that he was in negotiation with the federal government at that time, and urging, of course, the troops to drop their weapons. General Gowon went on to make a national broadcast on the eve of the official surrender of the 13-month war, his famous speech, No Victor, No Vanquished, and called for the reintegration of the Igbos into Nigeria. Exactly on 15th of January 1970, the Biafran delegation led by Major General Philip Effion included M.T. Mbo, Colonel David Ogunewe, and the Biafran military officers officially surrendered at Jordan Barracks to the troops of Nigeria. And guys, that was the end of the 30-month war. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Of course, the pertinent question we are going to be raising today is, was Ojukwu a hero or a coward for fleeing to Ivory Coast at the heat of the war? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Let me know what you think about the war. Let me know your thoughts on what. Know your thoughts on this. Let me know other comments. There are so many things I may not be able to capture the 13 months in a 9 minutes or 15 minutes video. Let me know other thoughts. Let me share your thoughts in the comment section with me, and I'll do well to reply them. It's your girl Naza Ugala, still on the Biafran series, and this is in commemoration with the Remembrance Day of Biafra, which occurs every 30th of May.